Today, we would like to start with a brief overview of water as a natural resource. The volume of water on the planet never changes. It is what we call a closed system, from below the ground to the atmosphere. So there is just as much water today as there was in the time of the dinosaurs, in the time of the Roman Empire, and in the time of King Henry VIII. And of all this volume of water, only about 2.5% of it is fresh, that is, usable for living beings and most plants. The rest of the water is too salty for most of the biological life. That is the global picture.
The local picture is that the amount of locally available water does change from one year to the next and from one era to the next. Locally available water is a function of rainfall and water found in streams and lakes and water underground close enough to the surface that it can be reached. The hydrologic cycle is that movement of water between oceans and clouds and rainfall and surface water and water locked up in glaciers and water under the ground. As the world population rises and moves from farms to cities, and as their standard of living improves, the local demand for water changes over time and location. And as the climate changes due to natural and man-made causes, then the supply also changes, perhaps producing too much water all at once in the case of flooding, or producing not enough water as in the case of droughts.
It's kind of analogous to what happens in a terrarium, a closed system where the water evaporates, condenses, and is recycled within a closed system. As we have said, the overall volume of water stays the same, but the shifting changes in the supply and demand creates tension. Many times it can create conflict, and sometimes, as in the case of flooding or drought, it creates even death.
So there is nothing boring or simple in this complex world of water. We hope you enjoy this course.